financial contagion cannot exist in the absence of integrated financial markets. So the first route is financial integration. Second has to do with the changing sentiment of investors. They could be very optimistic in the run-up to a crisis and very pessimistic afterwards. And finally, it is the absence of shock absorbers, elements of mutualization of the consequences of shocks, what makes contagion endemic. One can mention three main avenues through which contagion impacts markets and the economy. First of all is the channel from the banks to the sovereign, and this happens when the banks are in a very weak financial position. Second channel goes from the sovereign to the banks, and this occurs when the sovereign is in a weak financial position and banks have a lot of public debt, which is usually the case, in the balance sheets. And finally, given that the banking system is very prominent in the Eurozone, when the banks are in a weak position, they stop lending, and this has a very negative effect on the real economy. Vulnerabilities to contagion can be mitigated through a number of measures, but the most important at this moment in the Eurozone is to set up mechanisms that would permit absorbing shocks. This is what the banking union is meant to do, and this is what the measures of fiscal integration will do in the future. So this is the main building block in order to minimize contagion in the future. The measures taken by the governments when deciding to set up a banking union, and also by the central bank giving easy access to liquidity, are unfortunately not a magic wand. Banks will have to heal their wounds, they will have to reinforce capital positions before they start to lend, which means that companies will have to very carefully decide on investment, and governments could help in this respect, creating or giving access to non-bank funding sources.